When you're experiencing back pain, there's two things that you want. Firstly, you want to have some stretches which will help you with the pain right now. And secondly, you want to do some exercises which will help to prevent the back pain coming back in the future. That's exactly what I'm going to give you in this video. You will see my three favorite stretches to reduce the back pain right now, and I'll also give you the most effective strengthening exercises to help prevent the pain coming back in the future. Don't forget to download the free worksheet that comes with this video and the link you find in the description box down below. Let's get started. So one of my favorite exercises to deal with low back pain, my favorite stretches, is definitely the Bradsall 2.0 stretch. A fantastic, very intense stretch and a bit unusual. I don't think you've seen it anywhere else before. And what you need to do for this stretch is, so my left leg, I place my left leg in on the side of me. I've got 90 degree angle with my upper body and my left leg is perpendicular to the wall in front of me. Then my right leg is straight down, so I've got 90 degree angle between my two thighs. Now what I do is I place both hands about 30 centimeters in front of me. I sit upright and I turn now towards my left. So I turn, I place my right shoulder forward, turn towards my left, and I can already feel that in my lower back, especially a bit more on the left side than the right side. Now what I can do to accentuate this stretch is I can place my right hand underneath the palm of my left hand. Important to keep my right elbow straight. And now what I do is I lean towards my right. So I lean towards my right, and if I have any slack left, I'm rotating and turning my right shoulder forward. So keep my elbow straight and turn forward and lean as far to my right as I possibly can. And this is a great stretch for and the lower back, especially on the left side now, but also the left side of my outer thigh. So a fantastic stretch to stretch out the whole left lower back area. Now hold this for about 10 seconds and repeat about 5 times. This is called the Bradsall 2.0. So for the other side, if you want to accentuate the right side, what you do is again, my right leg, 90 degree angle, my body, and my upper leg perpendicular to the wall behind you. My left leg is now straight behind me. Now again, place my hands about 30 centimeters in front of me. Sit like this and rotate my left shoulder forward now as much as I can. So this now accentuates the stretch on the right side of my lower back. Yeah, I'm holding this stretch. And now what I do if I want to accentuate this, I'll place the left hand underneath the palm of my right hand, keep my left elbow straight, and now really leaning towards the left. And again, if I have some slack left, rotate my left shoulder forwards. Hold this for about 10 seconds and repeat 5 times. Again, I can really feel this on the more on the right side of my lower back, and especially also on the outside of my hip. So again, a great exercise, a stretch to deal with acute back pain and to help to reduce that back pain again. Again, hold this for 10 seconds and repeat about 5 times. That's the first exercise, and a very good one of my favorite exercises to do. The second exercise you should be doing is you should stretch out your flanks. So what you need to do for that is, let me demonstrate it to you. I'm now placing my right leg in front of me with a 45 degree angle, and I'm bending my left knee so my foot sits around my knee, just a bit above my knee. Now what I do is place my left hand next to the side. My right hand now goes over my ear. I'm stretching out now my right flank. So I'm stretching out my right flank. But the thing is, if you straighten your leg, what happens is you get a bit of more of a pull in your groin area on the left side. So you won't actually really stretch out your right flank area. So bend your leg, hand next to you, and now really reach up and try to reach as far as you possibly can towards the left with your right arm. So right arm is now over my ear. It's important that you don't turn and twist. So keep it to the side here. A fantastic stretch to do. Hold this again for about 10 seconds, repeat about 5 times. And you should really feel that on your right flank area. Yeah, and then obviously you can do the left side as well. So the left side, straighten up my left leg, bend the right knee, place my right hand next to me on the side, and then my left arm goes over my head, and I'm reaching the other side as far as I possibly can. Keep the right elbow straight. Reach out, you can really feel that on your left side, your left flank. So reach it to the side, don't twist and turn your body, hold it to the side. Repeat this 10 times, or hold for 10 seconds and repeat about 5 times to the side there. So that's a fantastic exercise to work on the flanks of your lower back. This is something you should be doing daily. And the last exercise I want to demonstrate to you is the corkscrew. Simple exercise as well to do. And what you do is you lay on your back. Straighten out your arms, so make sure there's a 90 degree angle here in your upper arms and your body. Bend your knees to this side, and then you turn, you rotate your knees towards, in this case, the left. Yeah, and now this is important, turn your head towards the right. So I'm turning my head towards the right. Push my right shoulder into the mat, into the ground, and hold this again for about 10 seconds. And what you can do is you can now play a little bit with your knees. So raise your knees up a little bit, so you feel a little bit more higher up in your lower back, or place your knees down a little bit. So it's a great area, or a great exercise to play around a little bit with. Hold this again for 10 seconds. And once you've done that, you just go to the other side. So then rotate your knees. Knees come to, in this case, to the right. I'm returning my head towards the left. Arms nice and wide. Pushing now our left shoulder into the bench or into the floor. And hold this again for about 10 seconds. And this is something you can do daily. You repeat about 5 times. So these are probably my 3 favorite stretches to do when you're suffering from back pain to reduce the pain quickly. And now we're going to move on. When the pain is gone, let's now move on to the next set of exercises you can do. Some really, really good and safe strengthening exercises which will help to prevent you with the pain in the future. So this next lot of exercises are exercises which will help to prevent the back pain coming back in the future. So they're strengthening exercises. Now, what's important with strengthening exercises is you want to strengthen the muscles without putting too much pressure on the back. And these exercises that I'm going to demonstrate to you are specifically designed to do that. So they're very, very safe exercises to do when you're dealing with back pain. So the first exercise we need to do is a sit-up, but a sit-up with a twist. So if you do normal sit-ups, there is a big chance that you actually re-injure your back again, because you're bending your back and you're putting too much pressure on your lower back. So we're doing a sit-up, which is invented by a guy called Stuart McGill. And what you do is you place, you lay on your back and you have a bent, in this case, my left leg. I'm placing my right hand now in the small of my back. So what I do is by bending my leg, I'm putting my spine into more of a neutral position, a safe position. And by placing the back of my right hand in the small of my lower back, I'm accentuating the natural arch that we have in the lower back, so preventing it from bending backwards and preventing it from creating more back pain. So this is our position, and all we do now is a sit-up. So we do a sit-up, but we come as high as the shoulders off the floor, like here, and you come back down again. And the same thing, so you do 10 of these, and you do 3 or 4 sets, or you could do 15, and 3 or 4 sets. And this is all we do. So this is a very good exercise to strengthen your core muscles. And this focuses on the straight core muscles in your tummy. So this is a very, very safe exercise to do. This is an exercise you should do at home. Now, whether you do it this way, and then you change your hand, your leg around, and you come up, it doesn't really make an awful lot of difference. But do this kind of exercise. I mean, change your hands. I mean, just to be 100% sure that you're targeting the right muscle. But you do 3 times 10 or 3 times 15 repetitions, and you do about 3 times, and you do this about once a day. So those are your straight line muscles. Now you also need to focus on the core muscles on your side, and a very safe exercise to do that is the side plank. So with the side plank, what you do is you lean on your, in this case, my right elbow. I'm now making sure that my legs are in straight line with my upper body. I've bent my knees. This is the first variation I'm going to demonstrate to you, the side plank. It's an easy one to do. So bend your knees, and all you do now is you raise your hips off the floor. And again, you hold this for about 10, 15, maybe even 30 seconds. And you repeat this about 3 times, right? 3 to 4 times. This is more like endurance exercise. So you hold this on the side. If this is easy for you or too easy for you, just straighten your legs and come up, and then come up the side. Make sure that your lower legs and your upper body are really, really away from the floor. You got a nice straight line here on the side. Push your hips up as far as you can, and again hold this, maybe hold for 20, 30 seconds, and repeat 3 to 4 times. Obviously you need to do the other side as well. So you do 3 sets of each of the side plank. It's a great exercise to do the side muscles. So we're on the front, the side muscles. Another very important set of muscles we need to do are the rotational muscles. They're like internal and external oblique muscles. Now, the best exercise to do for those muscles is an exercise called the dead bug. Let me demonstrate it to you. So what you do is you lay on your back, and now you place your arms in the air.
Yeah, as a 90 degree angle towards your body, and the same with your knees. Knees and ears as well, 90 degrees. Yeah. And now what we're going to do is, this is important. Please ensure that you keep your lower back pushed on the floor. Yeah. So don't arch your lower back. You're never allowed to arch your lower back with this exercise. The first thing we're doing is we're keeping the lower back on the floor and we're placing our right hand backwards. Yeah. That's number one. That goes well. That should go well without arching your back. Is then you straighten your left leg, your left knee without arching your back, that's important. If that goes well, now you're gonna combine it. So now you're gonna do left leg, yeah, and right arm back. And hold this again for about 10 seconds, and come back. And as I said before, it's important that your lower back does not arch. Always ensure that your lower back keep touching the floor, the mat, yeah? So this is a great exercise for your oblique muscles. So straighten your left leg, right arm goes back. You hold this for about 10 seconds, yeah, repeat this about 3 to 5 times. And then you go the other side. So straighten out my right leg, left arm comes back, 90 degree angle in my knee and my hip, 90 degree angle in my right shoulder here. Hold this again for 10 seconds and come back again. Yeah, and you do this. So I do each side 5 times at least, and you hold each execution, you hold for about 10 seconds. So that's called the dead bug, an absolutely brilliant exercise to work on your oblique core muscles. So with these three exercises, super safe to do for the back because the back stays in neutral. You can't really injure your back doing this. Now, with these exercises, you're targeting your straight muscles, your side muscles, and your oblique muscles, the ones that do the turning and the rotation. So you target all the muscles of your core, which all will help prevent your back pain coming back in the future. I hope this video was of value to you, and I hope that the stretches and the exercises I've demonstrated to you have helped you with your back pain. If you know someone who's struggling with back pain, don't hesitate and forward this video to them so they can help themselves as well. Don't forget to download the free worksheet that comes with this video, and the link is in the description box down below. For now, I'd like to say take care of yourself, take care of someone else please as well if you can, and bye for now. Bye bye.